what the most dangerous animal in Africa is?
Lion.
Oh, I'm not quite looking for that one. That's really pretty dangerous.
Hippo.
Dingo. All right, I'm gonna give you a hint. A snake. Think of a snake.
The black mama.
Yes. Perfect. Perfect. That's exactly what I was looking for. All right. So I'm gonna tell you a story today about a black mama. All right. So first, we're gonna start off in Africa. We're gonna go there. And in Africa, there's a missionary named Jason. So in Africa, a missionary named Jason is a missionary. And so that afternoon, there was a prayer meeting being held in the neighboring village. And he wanted to go hear that prayer. So to get to the neighboring village, he would have to walk through the wilderness to get there. So on his way, walking through the wilderness, he sees a stick, a gray stick. And so as he gets closer to the stick, it starts to move, and he thinks, oh, this is not a stick. And as he gets closer, the stick gets up, and above him, he looks at a great big serpent, a black mama staring right at him in the face. And he thinks, oh, no, he's in the middle of nowhere with this big snake. I could kill him. So he starts to run. And you know what the snake does? What do you think the snake did? It started to chase him. So he's running really fast, but the snake is still chasing him. And it's fast. And so you know, you can only run for so long before you start getting tired. So he's running and he's thinking, and he's like, what am I gonna do? Because the snake is going to catch me. So he starts praying and he says, God, please help me. So as he's running, on the left, he sees some brush. And he thinks, okay, I can go there. So he runs to the brush and he dives down and he gets really low and he hides. But you know what the snake does? It gets up really big, and it smells for him with its tongue, and it finds him, and it goes down and chases him. Jason gets up and runs, finds some more brush, and dives under and hides. Now this is going on for a while, and Jason's getting really tired, and he really is tired. And so he prays again, and he's like, God, I'm just going to run, and you're going to have to protect me, because I can't do this anymore. So he starts to run, and he's getting tired. He is. So he's running, and he's praying, and to his left, he sees a big tree. Okay, I'm just gonna go to that tree. And so he runs with all his might and he jumps, and he's a pretty good jumper. So he was able to grab a big limb above him and hang from it. But you know what the snake does? It waits underneath. So as he's hanging from there, the snake is underneath him. And guess what it does next? It starts to jump for him. So it starts to coil. And it jumps for him. And you know, it's getting pretty close as it's jumping. So as he's hanging there and he's tired, he starts to pray. And you know what he thinks? He thinks, I should let go. He feels that God is telling him to let go. But why would he let go? He's hanging from the tree and there's a snake under him. He's thinking, why? As the snake is coiling up and it's about to jump really hard, he's like, God, I'm going to trust you and I'm going to let go from this tree. That's pretty crazy. So as the snake is coiling up and about to jump for him, and as he lets go and the snake is jumping for him, his foot catches the snake's head and he lands and squashes its head. So, that's like, that's right. Anyway, he goes and he prays to God and he thanks him for what he did. But you know, we're a lot like Jason. We don't really trust God and we don't really want to let go of the branch. But when we do, good things happen and he works it out for us. Yeah. So I just wanted you guys